Welcome to a lesson on the percent of change. To calculate the percent of change, we take the ending amount minus the starting amount divided by the starting amount times 100%. If the result is positive, it is an increase, and if the result is negative, it is a decrease. Let's go ahead and take a look at a couple of examples. The value of a house was $150,000 in 2008, but now the value is $120,000. What is the percent change in the value of the home? So the ending amount is $120,000, and the starting amount was $150,000. So we're going to take this difference and divide by the starting amount, which was the $150,000. And then we'll take this, which will be the decimal form of the percent of change, and multiply it by 100%. Which, remember, is like multiplying by 1. We're just converting the decimal to a percent. 120,000 minus 150,000 is going to be negative $30,000 divided by $150,000 times 100%. Let's go ahead and use our calculator on this. Negative 30,000 divided by 150,000 equals negative 0.2, and then to convert this decimal to a percent, we're going to multiply by 100 and then add the percent symbol. So the percent of change is negative 20%, which means the value of the home has decreased by 20% since 2008. Let's go ahead and try another one. Let's say you currently make $36,000 per year, and then you were offered another job at $40,000 per year. What is the percent change in salary from your current job to the new job? So in this case, the ending amount is going to be the new salary of $40,000. Minus the starting amount, which is your current salary, $36,000, divided by the starting amount, which is the lower salary of $36,000. We're going to take this and multiply by 100%. So again, this will give us a decimal, and this converts it to a percentage. So 40,000 minus 36,000 would be 4,000. Divided by 36,000 times 100%. Again, let's just go ahead and use our calculator. So now we're going to have 4,000 divided by 36,000. This will give us a decimal. Then we multiply by 100 and then add a percent symbol. So times 100, it's going to be 11.1 repeating percent. Let's go and just call it roughly 11.1%. Because this is positive, that means the new salary would be approximately 11.1% higher than your current salary. Now, there's one more thing I want to discuss. Let's take a look at this situation. Maria owns $1,000 worth of stock and watches the percent change in the stock price regularly. One day, she sees the stock price drop 10% and panics. The next day, the stock price goes up 10%. She is happy because she thinks she has gained back all of her loss from the day before. Is she correct? It may seem that if it drops 10% and then increases 10%, the net change would be zero. But let's take a closer look at this. On day number one, we want to know what is 100% minus 10% of $1,000. So to answer this, we want to know what is 100% minus 10% will be 90% of $1,000. Well, if we use that percent equation, we would have x for the what, is means equals, 90% as a decimal would be 0.9, of means multiply, and then $1,000. Well, 0.9 times $1,000 would be $900. So she lost $100. Now for day two, we want to know what is 100% plus 10% of, and on the second day, it's not $1,000 anymore, it's $900. So she goes into day two with $900, and that amount will increase by 10%. So the real question becomes, what is 110% of $900? Well, again, going back to our percent equation, we have x equals 110% of the decimal is 1.1 of means multiply $900. Well, 1.1 times $900 is equal to $990. So in fact, if she loses 10% on one day and then gains 10% the next day, she does not break even because she's only earning this 10% on the lower amount of $900. So she started day one with $1,000 and ended day two with $990. So she's still down $10. So in fact, it takes a higher percent of return to make up for the same percent loss. And this is quite surprising to a lot of people, but now you know the difference. I hope you found this video helpful, and thank you for watching.